Not sworn to any particular Chaos god, the Dark Elf War Queen seeks the favour of all. She has slain countless foes and bested many great war beasts. In today's tutorial, we're going to show you a quick way of painting the Dark Elf War Queen, making good use of shades to really help get that model ready for battle in no time. To follow this method, you'll need to undercoat the model with Korax White Spray, like I've done here. The reason for this will become more apparent in the following stages. Firstly, I'm going to make a mix of Rykon Fleshane and Larmium Medium. We're going to apply this all over the model, but it's predominantly for the skin and the horns, but it will make a great base for all the other colours that we'll apply later. So I'm just going to mix the pots together, pop them back open. One thing I like to do is use Larmium Medium first. Always apply that to the palette using a medium shade brush, because that's appropriate for this. For the mix, we need two paintbrushes of Larmium Medium and one paintbrush of Rykon Flesh Shade. And then we're just going to slap it all over the model. Start with the face and just work our way down. With our shade mix now dry, we're ready to move on to the next stage. And for this, we're going to use Seraphim Sepia. We'll be applying that to any horns, skulls, and there's a couple of runes on the back of the cloak. We'll use a medium layer brush. I'm going to use it straight from the pot, but I will use my palette just to get a bit more control on my brush. And then I'll start applying it to the horns. A little bit of neatness is key here. Don't have to go too mad though. With the shade now applied to the horns and bones, we're ready to move on to the next stage, which is to start applying base coats. Firstly, we're going to jump into using Leadbelcher. We're going to cover all the areas like the axe, the shield, the crown, gauntlets, and chainmail. As always, we're just going to apply some paint to our palette. I'm going to thin this down a lot more than I normally would, as this will give me more control in running over those areas. And once we start applying shades, it will look all right. I'll just start slapping it on like here. Like I said, don't worry about it being too thin down. This is fine. For this, to give it more control, I'm going to be using a medium layer brush. Also, don't forget the areas like the crown, chainmail, just under there, and the axe, of course. And with that now dry, we're ready to move on to using Balthazar Gold to pick out all the areas like the shoulder pauldron, the big belt buckle, the sword scabbard, and some other little details around the model as well. So as always, like previously, we'll just thin that down. And again, I'm going to thin this down a little bit more than normal. I'm also using a medium layer brush as well, just to give me a bit more control. And then I'll start with a shoulder pad, start applying that on there. So again, with it being a bit more watered down, it just flows around a lot easier, gives you more control. There's also the details on the shield to consider. And we've got the belt buckle just under here. And there's the sword scabbard as well, so I'll apply it all on there. Those metallics applied, we've just got a few more base coats to apply. We're going to use Mournfang Brown, Mephiston Red, and Abaddon Black. I'll start with Mournfang Brown first. This is going to be useful for all the van braces, the fur on the back of the cloak, and the loincloth as well. And as always, I'm just going to thin it down using a medium layer brush, and we'll just start slapping on. I'll start on the fur first. Because it's a bit thinned down, it just runs into those recesses a lot easier. Like I said, there's also the van braces, and then there's the loincloth. We're just going to do the inside of the loincloth, as the outside will be doing Mephiston Red. After the Mournfang Brown's applied, we're going to go straight on to using Abaddon Black. And again, we're going to thin this down. And I'll start on the boots and the fur around the boots. Again, because it's watered down, it's going to go in a lot easier. Also, you've got some belts to do and are undergarments. I would recommend swapping to a smaller brush for this, so use a small layer. And I'll just jump on that right now, just finish that bit there. So we'll get a smaller brush. We've just got straps just at the side of a breastplate there we need doing. Got the belt just there. Like I said as well, there's the undergarments just underneath. You might not be able to see it from there, but they're definitely there. Once the Abaddon Black's dry, we're going to move on to using Mephiston Red. And again, thinning this down, we're just going to apply this on the weapon halves like here. There's also the dagger just underneath the shield there. That's also got some leathery red work on it. And then there's the cloak as well. So the back of the cloak's fairly straightforward. You can just slap that on as you wish. However, when you get to the underside of the cloak, I would thin it down a lot more just to give you a bit more control, especially this area here, and just let that red run in and just take your time with this. And I'm using a small layer brush for this just to give me a bit more control, but don't force it and don't rush it. And also, don't forget the loincloth at the front. Now that we've applied all the base coats, ready to add a whole bunch of shades to the model. And the first one I'm going to use is Agrax Earthshade. We're going to apply this to all the metallics, the cloak, the fur, and also to the tips of the horn to give it a nice gradient. I'm using a medium layer brush for this, just to give me more control. And as always, I'm just going to apply it to my palette. I'm not going to thin it down, I'm just going to use it straight from the pot. And we'll start by slapping it onto the model. So I'll start with all the metallics. Because I've done them both the same together, I can just quite casually lay this on here. I'm not too concerned about neatness there. We've also got areas like the weapon haft. Again, you can be quite liberal with how much you apply there because you've got the metallics there as well. Like I said, we've got the cloak at the back here. So we just slap it on there. When I mentioned about adding it to the tips of the horns, we're probably just going about a third of the way. So give it a nice gradient. So about there should do it. After giving that shade enough time to dry, we're ready to move on to the next stage. And for this, we're going to use Norn oil, and we're just going to start applying this to all those deep recesses on the metallics and also on the tips of the horns as well. Again, we're just going to apply it to the palette. I'm going to use it straight from the pot. And I'm going to be using a medium layer for this. Just going to run that around the cracks of the shield. Like so. And then also just on the tips. And this is right near the tips, not even a third way down, just right on the very tips. And again, to give it a bit more gradient. After giving the Norn oil about half hour to dry, we're going to move on to using Fugan Orange. We're just going to apply this to the hair, and I'm going to do a couple of coats of this just to give it a bit more strength and depth. So I'm going to use it straight from the pot. Again, I'm using a medium layer here. It's got a little touch of water, actually. And then, like I said, we're just going to do a couple of coats of this. That'll give it that nice fiery ginger hair. With Fugan Orange applied to the hair, we're now ready to move on to the highlights. For the reds, we're going to use Evil Sun Scarlet and Wild Rider Red. We're going to highlight all the metallics with Stormo Silver. We're going to highlight all the browns with Scrag Brown. And we're going to highlight all the black areas with Dawnstone. We'll start with the reds first. So I've got my small layer brush ready. I'm going to use Evil Sun Scarlet. I'm just going to add a little bit of water to that. It's also worth actually probably changing your water at this point because it's probably got a bit dirty from all the other colours you've used. So I've got some fresh for this. We'll start with the cloak. We'll just start running that around the edges. With the red highlight, I would probably make this one a bit chunkier because when you do the next highlight, you want to be a bit thinner. And also, don't forget, go down the folds as well. Just give that cloak a nice flowing look. With the first highlight applied, we're now going to use Wild Rider Red and do a fine edge highlight. We're going to use the edge of the brush when we're going around the areas like the cloak here. This needs to be a bit smaller than the last highlight. When doing the fold of the cloth, we're just going to use the tip of the brush and just be really careful and draw a line down like so. And now we're ready to start highlighting all the metallics. And for this, we're going to be using Stormo Silver. We'll use a small layer brush for this. Now we're going to start highlighting all the brown areas. We're going to use a small layer brush and we'll highlight with Scrag Brown. We'll be picking out the fur. You could dry brush this if you wish to. We've also got the van braces at the back of the gauntlets. And there's also the loincloth just at the bottom there. Next, we're going to start highlighting all the black. For most of this, we're just going to pick out the raised details using Dawnstone. This I'm using a small layer brush, as you can see here. And we'll do this on the belt, as well as the boots, and you've got the scabbard there as well. So I'll just run that down the side. For the fur around the top of the boots, I'm actually just going to layer that with a few bits of black just showing through. It'll give it another texture. As you can see, we're almost there. We've just got a few more details to pick out. The next step is just to finish some details on the skin. And for this, we're going to use Reichland Flesh Aid, Caribou Crimson, and Flavor on Flesh. I'll start off with the Reichland Flesh Aid. I'm going to use a small layer brush for this. Let's get some on my palette. Add a little bit of water. And for this, I'm just going to pick out some of the crevices in the hands, around the joins and the legs, around the eye sockets and the mouth. So not too much work there, just to add a bit more definition. I'll just start on the eyes. Ooh. Sometimes you can blob that on, so don't worry about that. Just use your brush to soak some of it up. Drop that in there. Around the knee, I'm just going to add a little bit to the knee. Just a little bit in the muscle there. As I said earlier, where the fingers are there, just drop a little bit into the finger cracks there. Just give it a bit more shade. Once that's dry, we're ready to start adding the Caribou Crimson. We're going to apply this on all the scars. There's one on a midriff and one on a thigh. And we're also going to add it to the eyes and the mouth. Just give it a real savage look. So I'm just going to use a small layer brush again. Add a little touch of water to it. I think I'll start with the scars first. And then we'll just run that down like so. Give it that fresh, kind of dried scar look to it. Got the one on the midriff just about here. And then we'll just run it to the eyes. And with that done, we're ready to start highlighting the skin. And for this, we're going to use Flayed On Flesh. I'm going to use a small layer brush. I'm only going to highlight things like the nose, the cheeks, the knuckles on the hands. And also, I'll pick out bits on the scars as well. As always, I'm just going to thin it down slightly. And we'll just start highlighting it. Let's pick out the nose to start off with. Just be careful with this. This is the bit you want to spend most of your time on. And with that, the skin is done. All that's left now is to highlight all the bone areas. And for this, we're going to use Screaming Skull and Pallid Witch Flesh. With the Pallid Witch Flesh, I'll also use that just to put some dots in the eyes as well. But we'll start with Screaming Skull. We'll just pick out all the bone areas. Like so. And for this, we'll be using a small layer brush. And the final step is just to highlight the raised areas of the bone with a bit of Pallid Witch Flesh. Also, it'll be worth just using this just to add a little dot to the eyes. So this will really help bring it to life. As you can see, the model is finished and ready to be based. I'd recommend basing it in the same style as the rest of your army. With the model finished and based, she is now ready to forge a legacy within the mortal realms. There are a few key points to remember when following this tutorial. Firstly, for the shading method to work, it's necessary to use Corax White as an undercoat. Secondly, when applying all those shades, just take your time, don't rush through it. And lastly, always use multiple thin layers, as we don't want to clog up those details. I hope you guys have enjoyed this tutorial, and I hope to see you soon. Bye bye.